Hold on for fuck's sake.
Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Jeroen van Leverloo.
Can you pull those bolts straight out, maybe? In the back?
In the back?
Yeah, maybe.
No.
Alright, got it.
I made progress on Batman Stealth for years. Hitting a break. Take away my light.
I was having trouble getting a good shot.
Jesse,
yeah.
Go around the back, see if you can get those four bolts to unthread out.
There's only two left.
Or two left.
These two.
Okay.
Should be three-quarter inch.
Lift up on it.
I really can't.
All right. Maybe. I'm making movement.
There we go.
All right. Lift. Wiggle it. Oh, I got it.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
Oh, my God.
It just take me 5 minutes. It's easy.
I got the first one out in 5 minutes, didn't I?
You got the first one out in about 12 minutes.
Nah, it wasn't 12 minutes, fucker. With those studs in my way.
Which studs? Oh, on the sides?
Yeah. Are there bolt heads on the other side or something?
No. There. It doesn't even go through.
Fuck.
They're welded studs.
No, they're these stupid flat studs.
Yeah, they're in between the two layers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
we have to lift then, don't we? Batman?
Well, I don't know if we can really lift.
You got airspace.
Oh, we were closer.
God damn.
Can you get...
There we go.
Hang on, hand.
Yeah.
Those are surprisingly beefy.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a little weight to that.
Just a scooch.
Like, I think those would hold up to an impact better than the damn cabinet would.
All right, come around the other side and come catch it.
Yay!
If I get it out.
Now we take out the hardware we put on truck.
You want this brush thing behind me?
Eh.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
I missed a bolt.
You missed a bolt?
Nut, whatever. We both checked it though, so it's not just my fault.
You're getting blamed.
I know.
Oh, look at how effortlessly it comes off now.
That one caught, so. You want the sides off too?
That can't be good.
What?
A big part just fell off the door. Big washer thing?
It's not needed. It's weight reduction.
Big wheel thing's hanging out the door now too.
Probably explains the loud...
I told you that that was broken.
Probably explains the loud clunk when it's been going up and down.
Maybe. We'll have to fix that.
I told you about that. We have to call a dude to do it.
Can't afford the dude.
Which is exactly what you said. Because it's the part that's under tension. Go figure.
So you gotta show me what to do on the tamper thing. Mm-hmm. Show Batman. He'll understand it better. Alright. Cool, that's done. Before you take off, let's put this on the truck real quick.
Okay.
That'll just take a second. Alright. Let's take a look with Jesse and see what he's got with the thing. And then we'll toss this on the truck. Then when it's on the truck, we'll take the last couple little bits out of the inside there. Hi there, guys. Welcome to today's Captain's Vlog. It's 12:32 hours on Tuesday, May 3rd, 2016. I'm Chris Boden, and you're not.
And I didn't do
back. Slide it all the way forward.
Sure. Move the freaking van.
Okay, now I grab the other one, that'll fill up the last Tetris spot, and we're set. That needs a little love. That needs a lot of love. I can't do that. Huh?
Where the hell are you at?
Just before the fender.
Yeah?
Looking under the...
Okay. Got it. Sharp edge here. Batman?
I heard you.
Give me a little block of something.
Okay.
Something I can put around this edge to protect it so you don't shred the thing. What are you doing? Why would you not just right over?
Because I don't have anything to hook because of the fenders. There's fenders.
Oh, that'll work.
I'm going to put a piece straight over this short one you're fucking with.
All right. Go ahead. And nice. Oh, wait. Hey. Hang it. Here. Give me a second.
You don't have to worry about hooking it on the small one. I'm going to have a separate strap for that guy.
Oh, we're going to worry about this one?
We're just doing these two big things.
All right. Then you're fine.
That still may come in handy.
Yeah. I'm going to save that.
You know what, we're probably going to want to push those together, Batman.
That'll be alright.
Alright.
They're under a significant tension and he's only going like 8 miles.
I'm surprised we don't just have a padnose dumpster.
We do, from time to time.
Yeah.
It's kind of expensive, actually.
Is it? I just figured as much as they got out of here, they'd do it for us, you know.
We don't get enough to justify it. I need my thing.
See? Is that edge sharp too?
Hey, Batman. Is that edge sharp? Yeah, but we're square on it, so it's not as bad as most of them.
Yeah, it's when you hit them off.
At that angle
offset.
Was,
yeah.
I'm still going to put it in there just because I'm
fingers.
So we got to place that.
We got a climbing wall.
Yeah, that's almost tall enough for Jerry.
I think we give him a good chance.
I took one look at that and went, "What? Do I just step all the way up?"
Of yours to the front post.
Now, we have to put it in here. We need the best space to do that. We can't put it here because of plumbing. We want to put it here, but it's tricky.
We can't block the door.
We can put it up against that wall. Alright, hang on a minute. Before we move it, we have to prep a little bit. Batman, I need every garden rake we have. Garden rake are the short tines and hard. Okay. People standing, grab anything in here that is trash or tree parts, like big stuff. We're about to cover this in pea gravel, so we want to have a relatively clean environment to do that with. Elizabeth, grab a big trash can, please. Take two.
You're going to need to carry on the driver.
I don't know.
dogs can poop all they want. It just goes through the pea gravel.
It's on cinder blocks.
No, that does not count as a concrete foundation.
I understand that.
You can pour a concrete foundation.
Yeah, I can.
I'll even let you borrow the cement mixer. We have a cement mixer.
Why am I surprised by
that? Yeah, that's fine.
Fucking 17 years I've known the man, he still surprises me. 18? Yes. Yeah, I know. 99 to 16.
Have you breaks yet?
No.
Yeah, we're just not here.
You two, go and help get breaks.
More importantly, where's my shipping?
The whole dog yard.
It can be, yes.
Alright, what we need to do is just chew this up and level it out. We are not here to move giant amounts of material, just smooth it out.
Wait, pea gravel. We're gonna have a Zen garden.
Batman, I trust you to find any tools that you see.
What about large rocks?
How large?
No, that's not a large rock.
Large rock takes two hands. Katie! Come here. The idea is to use this to chew up the top inch or so.
Cast it!
Smooth that out. Find high spots, pull them low.
Huh? Cast it!
What? Care if I take that bike tire or that bike rim?
The one that's in the Gaylord? The one that's in the Gaylord, yeah.
Is it in the Gaylord?
Yeah.
Let me take a look. Probably you can have it.
I think I asked you yesterday. It's a bike rim.
Is one of those Gaylords over there?
Yeah, because the dogs keep cutting themselves on them.
Hey, Ed. Take that shovel, go right next to the sidewalk there by the door. It goes all the way up. Pull it. Just scoop it and pull it in. We want to go down a couple inches. Not a lot, but just a couple inches. For what?
Make a sweet deal.
That boat?
Fuck, I got
how many boats you want?
Got seven water craft. Six here. I think one, two, two. Jet ski? That's a.
I put it on supply. But...
See, that's what. We know what's wrong with the jet ski. It wasn't going to be much.
Yeah, but a bunch of them.
Okay.
Yes, I flew. So it did.
Yeah? Cool. Have them talk to him.
see the attic of the pedal boat. Said motor requires two people to work on it.
Mackie!
Oh, shit.
Hey.
Yes,
Mackie!
Yes.
Hey.
Shovel. I want to see the dogs.
It's a bigger stick.
Hi.
I'm gonna have to pick you up.
Yes.
If you can get that close.
Give me a stick. Give me a stick.
Yeah. Give me a stick.
Yeah.
Like
that? Yeah, that's lovely.
No.
Work it down his head. Work right down his head.
I should be drunk.
Because the dirt we can just spray out.
Already.
But the idea is to...
There was a truck here, an asshole left. If there's a situation, it's like this.
All this, we can peel it away, and then the people that will sit,
it's sold.
The dirt we can just take us.
And we shipped the keys. I disabled the shift interlock.
Yes.
But the wheels are turned, and the steering
goes way through.
And I don't want to pick it up.
There's so much dog traffic out here now. Nothing.
We're working on that. But there's no overhang because camper van, and he brought a trailer, what he said.
The grass is fucked. I've been trying to
figure out. Yeah, I haven't even seen his rig. He just duped out. Also has a very heavy Russian accent. Because I'm an asshole, I want him to say Moose and Squirrel. Way before you. Not no Rocky and Bullwinkle.
I do know Rocky and Bullwinkle, but I just never really watched it as well.
I taped that next piece because I'm an asshole. Yeah. These kids are going to get around, man.
He'll be back. Keep on trucking. It'll shred that up into little pieces.
Keep stalling.
That's not terrifying at all. That's the greatest idea ever. Hey, you got an air going over there?
No, it won't reach. Never mind.
It's totally not terrifying. It's the safest thing I've ever done.
Am I in danger over here?
No, you're fine. Totally. Everything's fine. Everything's okay, Brian. Everything's awesome.
We're all fine here. How
are you? Alright, so we're gonna have one there, one there, one there, one there, one there, one there. Yes! Not terrifying at all. Just don't drill a hole through the giant bag. It's gonna be great. We're totally safe. Nobody has to die today. Drill through the big lead bar in the pan. Remember, boys and girls, when you're drilling through a giant multi-ton battery, keep your mouth closed. Because that's the real danger. That's enough ass puckering. Okay, now we just gotta vacuum the stuff off. Because I want to get rid of all the little lead shards so that the cat can eat them. We'll be back. Alright, we're doing the page 18.
So yeah, we're holding hamper.
Yeah?
Oh, those are totally what you're doing. They're way more. Red is one.
Today.
Red here.
Because actually I guess it's sold while they were in Maryland, and the guy paid up for it. Well, paid in full. So Bruce sent out, you know, title and probably bill of sale, that kind of stuff that I expected the guys to do.
And I'll take a short screw on the washer.
So,
dude, not fucking pull on it.
First, fucking pull on it, asshole.
That's good screw. It's a wrong fucking screw.
I got lucky enough to disable the shift. So I can get it out of here. But the steer, the wheels are turned, the steering wheel's locked. Yeah. So the guy went, oh shit. I could call my boss and wait. I was fine. No. I don't know where he, you know, it's a shipping company. I don't know how they work that. Hey, it's the cat!
Cat's back. He's come home.
So, but since we've had time to try and get another driver out here.
It's a secure connection.
Who's made tomorrow? Because I called the Foxman place up the road again. I can't remember the name.
Okay, that's it.
They said we could be on call for Thursday.
Blue is two? Because blue is always two with Batman.
Doesn't do us a lot of good.
Short screw, wash.
Who's finally got through? Dealership. I got to get pulled on, put on the
okay.
She got a whole dealership. They're
going to you want to not crimp down on the.
So she's out getting the key. Yeah. I put the steering column
back
together.
Just barely clears it. Yeah, just ever so slightly. Just clears it.
borders on, yeah, it borders on problems when you disable shifted or off the ignition switches. We have a few
more. Of course, we don't want to do this with a drill because we don't want to strip out the lid real fast.
Yeah, but I know. It's one of those big kind of great things.
This black one might need a little love, but we'll sort it. Black one here.
It's stripped.
Yeah, it needs to be stripped.
Oh, the black wire.
We don't know if it's energized
heating,
but we don't want
the heat shrink over the print.
Connector. Okay, well, yeah. I was like, don't tell me to strip it all. Why don't you strip it all?
Nah, this one's plenty.
Okay.
Hey, the screw's different.
Hmm?
The screw's different. Okay, that's better. No, we just
they're
sheet metal screws, but not self-tapping. We drilled a hole.
If you used in enough metal, they're self-tapping.
Every screw is a self-tapping screw.
Can I build this one with those? It's fighting me wrong.
They're really big terminals, and we didn't want to mess with the cables because there's an inline fuse 4 inches from the end.
I say they have stickers all over that says "Do not cut the wire," so we didn't.
And you're now going to take this one out. That's way easier the second time.
Ben!
Way easier the second time.
This one's close, but I'm trying to do it. Do it right the first time. So don't have a fire.
And I want you to notch these just enough to let the wire out, but I want to cover these under the things, okay?
just like Dremel or something. We just need a notch cut here and here. But I want to have yellow wrapping all the way around.
Yeah.
And the black ones. That's all three. We should be able to plug it in testing.
I gotta cut this other one too.
It'd be amazingly awesome if we could just have this plugged in like we do the fluoroscope all the time.
As long as this charger doesn't chooch this battery, there's no reason why we can't.
I'm not worried about the charger fucking the battery up. I'm worried about the battery being too dead for the charger to kick on. That's my concern. That's aside from that, we should be totally cool.
So that's the only reason I am.
Because the charger, if it's below 2 volts a cell, the charger won't pick up. That's what it says, and we're right at that bar.
Yeah, and then they just
hold
down the straps.
My only other concern is the charger is designed for batteries much smaller than this.
Yep.
And it might wig out because of that. That goes down way more tighter than that.
No, that's what it was.
Alright, I'll
plug it
in.
Screw now.
Clear?
Clear.
Take tools off the battery.
Tools are off the battery.
Plugging it in.
Yeah.
AC power light on. Battery tag comes up as flooded, so it's got that. It's doing the self test to make sure it's okay. That goes solid, we're good.
They've got like yards.
But it may take up to 2 minutes to do this. But it's making sure that everything is wired up in the right polarity and the right voltages and all that jazz. But we got 2 out of 3 lights good. We get the third light good. And then the charging light comes on and we're set.
A green light just came on.
Where? Up here?
Yeah.
Well, that's cool. Hey, we're officially charging.
Woo.
It's working. Now we
won't really know until we turn on the forklift and see if it actually works.
Yeah, but at this point, it's charging.
Yeah,
it's
the charger
working.
Is energized. It thinks it's charging. Anyway.
Yeah, but it accepted the batteries. They're not too low for the charger to kick on.
Oh, I see what you mean.
If they're too low, it won't kick on. So that's good. That means that this should work. And now we can just let this do this all night long and not have to worry about it. We can just leave it plugged in for days. And someday, a week from now, it may come out of charging mode and go to conditioning mode. And I'm okay. I'm okay if it takes a week, because it's just, it's quietly doing its thing, and we don't have to check on it every 10 minutes and be like, oh, it's too hot on the outside. Nope.
We don't have to hear the IRC bitch about the buzz of the charger and the MDA.
Yeah, you'll notice how loud it is.
Yeah, so it's just not
gotten loud. Can we junk the charger now?
The big charger?
No.
No.
It's 36 volts.
At like 20 amps, which is fun.
Yeah. He said high voltage parts.
High amperage parts, whatever.
But in the big clean out, do you want to get rid of the two smaller chargers?
I was going to get rid of it. Well, at least the one. The blue one was for that forklift.
Yeah, but we're going to decom the forklift.
Yes, it will.
Right, but if you got a charger and a good battery, you could sell them.
He walked away without paying.
Chris.
Yeah. If you have a good battery and a good charger that goes with it, you make money and decide what we get from scrap.
Yeah.
Call homeboy at That's actually something they'll want.
Yeah, that's a good point.
You might give me a couple hundred bucks just for a charger, though.
Good luck. Is surplus, dude?
Yeah.
He'll give you $5 for the truck. The guy's kind of a dick.
Well,
we'll be back.
Yeah.
Will the combined space occur?
Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Jeroen Van Leverloo, who just went from $2 up to $25. I may not be saying your name right, but that's I'm going with Jeroen Van Leverloo. So, thank you, sir.
Midway through my time at the Army, at least.
And check that out. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Thank you, Denichi.
On the count of two. Wide swing.
Now, which side's the top, or does it not matter?
It doesn't matter.
Okay.
If you care, this is the bottom.
Okay. Everybody, come on in. We're gonna go that way?
You gotta swing out.
We're swinging.
And let's put it right side up. Up against the building.
Oh my God.
The corner lines up with the corner of the building, okay? So we're gonna put it right here. Stop! We're gonna line this end up with the corner. Up tight to the building and just set it down right there.
Want it laying flat?
Yeah.
Toast.
Cool. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Stable.
Why did we not start on this side? Why did we start on that side?
That side isn't covered in roots.
Huh?
Cool.
Where you were working.
Now we just got to level out under it, now that we know exactly where we're going, everything, and we're all set.
Okay.
So it's going to be all right.
Tamping tool.
We're just going to put summer blocks under it so the frame doesn't rot out of this.
It's made of aluminum.
It's not even shit.
It's got a protective sapphire coating.
Ridiculous shed base.
Yeah, this is so over-engineered as a shed base, but it'll do. It's what we have. And it's much more practical than my idea, which was way more awesome as an application for it.
I'm so glad we didn't go with
your
idea.
Yeah.
It's kind of long for what you wanted to do.
It'll work.
No, I'm saying your first idea.
Oh, it'll work. Someday I'll get to build a railroad go-kart. Someday. But for now, we have a very practical shed, so, yeah.
If you're light enough, you can just keep the engine in there. You can pick it up,
when you want to use as a go-kart, just move it home to a truck.
It'd be a little difficult
with the thing that's going to be in
a shed on top of it. Yeah. We need housing for the vacuum table stuff.
Also, the puppies need a shadow.
Oh, no. I got a plan for that. That's the base for the doghouse.
Oh, my God.
Is that the best idea or what? It's the base for the doghouse. Where do you want to put the doghouse?
The dogs use the other doghouse somewhere.
Well, we're going to make a better doghouse.
Yeah.
I want to make a doghouse that's kind of a carport style.
Okay. Well, I'm going to put that past the shed over there.
They love to hang out right
because it's a shady spot.
They like to hang out by the sign and watch people at the intersection.
Okay. So, cool. All right. A couple of people grab that and set it wherever you would like the doghouse to be. That's upside down, just so you know.
Also, one half is loose.
It won't matter. Jesus, that thing stinks. Try it now.
Worst cases.
It didn't work before. So
yeah.
It doesn't work now. Not having it. Hey, Katie! Oh, she's doing it.
Power booster. You have to have a master cylinder. File down the real front points.
Yeah, these two. Yeah.
File those down a bit, because that's.
Yeah.
Seems really sharp for a key at that.
Yeah, I think I could cut skin with that. Cool.
Have them up those down a bit.
Yeah.
Then we'll go look at the fire truck. I'll show you what I'm talking about.
try this.
It's slightly better. I can now steer the steering wheel. Better. That's funny. He's close. we can turn the steering wheel now.
Isn't that all we need?
Yeah.
Tell me I was able to get the steering wheel to turn very close, but we were...
Okay. All right. We got the steering wheel to turn now, but it won't turn over.
Huh?
The steering wheel will turn now, but it won't turn over.
That's all we...
Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Geraldine Van Leverloo.